Man in the middle attack and sniffing. In this video, I will show you how you can gather password information using man in the middle attack sniffing technique. Let me introduce lab scenario of my PC. Here I have VMware workstation installed in my laptop and I've installed some different operating system in VMware. And I have an operating system like Kali Box, Windows 10 and Win2K12. These are the IP address settings for Win2K12 operating system. This IP address is used for Windows 10 operating system and this IP address used for Kali Linux operating system. In this video, I will install Telnet server and Telnet client service in Win2K12 and in Kali Linux, Telnet client service is already installed during Kali Linux installation. And in Windows 10, I will install Kane and Abel sniffing software to gather information about the remote machine. Here I will request for Telnet connection from Kali Linux to Win2K12 and Win2K12 provide terminal of Win2K12 by authenticating username and password. So when Kali Linux try to establish connection with Win2K12, it will first send traffic to the Windows 10 machine and then Windows 10 send traffic to the Win2K12 and Win2K12 respond to Windows 10 machine and then Windows 10 provide data to the Kali Linux. So this machine will work as man in the middle and this machine gather information of Kali Linux and Win2K12. So in this video I will show you how you can gather password information using Kane enable software. So let's begin. Here I have a Kali Linux operating system, Windows Server 2012 and Windows 10 operating system. Let me log in with root account in Kali Linux. Here you can see IP address of Kali Linux is 246. Windows 10 has IP address 228. And Windows Server 2012 has 240. So now just open Server Manager. Let me maximize this virtual machine. Go to the Add Role and Features. You can also go to the Add Role and Features by this Manage option. Click on Add Roles and Features. Click on Next, 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 Next. Here you will see Telnet server, Telnet client, and let me install TFTP client also. Now click on Next. Restart the destination server automatically. If required, click on Install. It will take a few seconds. Let me download Kane and Abel software. Just open Internet Explorer. Just open google.com. Now search for Kane and Abel. Click on this link. Go to the download kNN-able version 4.9.56 for Windows NT 2000 and XP. Click on Save As, select Desktop, Save. Here you can see blocked by smart screen. Download unsafe file. It will take 1 minute and 36 seconds. Here you can see installation succeed on Win 2K12. Just click on close. And now you need to go to the services. Just click on services. Make sure Telnet service is running. Click on automatic, apply, start, and click on OK. IP address of Win 2K12 is 240. Now go to the Kali Linux box, ping to the 192.168.159.240 machine. We can ping to the remote machine. Now need to telnet 192.168.159.240. Now need to give username of the remote machine. Give password of the remote machine. And here you can see we can access remote machine using Telnet service. So it's working fine. Here you can see cssetup.exe contain virus and that's why it is deleted. Make sure you are logged in with normal user. Now need to disable Windows Defender. Go to the Windows Defender Security Center and click on Virus and Threat Protection. Make sure it is off. Now go to the app and browser control and make sure it is not blocking. Okay, now download again, save as, desktop, click on save. Download unsafe file. It will take around 3 minutes or 2 minutes to download kNN-able software. Click on view download and just run anyway. Click on run anyway. Click on yes. Just click on next, 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 next. Finish. Click on install. Click on OK. Here you can see kNN-able symbol. Just double click on it. Now you can see start or stop sniffer option. Here you can see APR option. Now you need to just click on start or stop sniffer. You can see IP address of this machine. Just click on it and click on OK. Sniffer is started. Now need to click on, here you can see sniffer is started. Now you just need to click on APR icon, and here you can see plus icon is not highlighted. Just you need to click on this area, it will highlight it. Just click on it. Host list is empty. Please scan MAC address first. So we need to scan MAC address first. So just click on cancel and need to go to the sniffer option. Just click on this icon and click on OK. It will scan entire network. It will take few seconds or few minutes to gather information of the network machines. Here you can see we can get information of 192.168.159.2. 254 is also detected. Still sniffer is working. Let it scan for a while. Host has been detected. You can see 246 is IP address of Kali Linux and 240 is IP address of Win2K12. Now you need to click on APR. Just click on this area and just click on plus icon. Here you can see IP address list. Now we need to communicate between Kali Linux 2 Win2K12. Win2K12 IP address is 240. So just select IP address of Kali Linux and need to click on Win2K12 and just click on OK. Here you can see we can gather information of the 246 and 240 IP address. So when communication established between 246 to 240, it will give information about passwords, etc. So now we need to just open Kali Linux operating system. Just log in into Kali Linux operating system. Just run telnet command. You need to give username of the remote machine and password of the remote machine. Now you just need to go to the Windows 10 machine. Here you can see password options. Just click on password tab. Here you can see telnet has one symbol. Just click on it. Just right click on this area and just click on view. Here you can see login credentials and login username is administrator and password is 123@abc. So hope you understand how attacker can gather passwords information by man in the middle attack technique.